Howdy folks, Rev Todd from Primitive Guitars. Yeah, that guy does own two of mine. Here is what's going on. This one just got finished for my friend's hubby. It's gonna be awesome. Grab it here. Look at the back. Nice. 23 inch scale, it's kind of my thing. It's gonna be a nice guitar. It's gonna be awesome. Working on this little beauty right now. There's the Wicked Bucker. It's gonna go right over here. This one, I kind of spent some random time trying to figure some stuff out. So there's paddock there. This neck is actually kind of checkerboardy. Paddock down there. Look at that. That is nice. This one. I might keep. Not sure. Anyways, gonna show you guys and gals and everybody else some of the different styles of guitars that I make. So if you would like one, you can choose a style. I have a handful of boxes, so that's not a problem. So let's get into it. So this is what I call a slide guitar. I don't just call it a slide guitar. Everybody calls it a slide guitar. This is probably the most basic version of a guitar that I'll build. The most primitive. Still is electric. There's actually what's called a rod piezo under there, which is going to give kind of an acoustic sound. Obviously put distortion on it and she makes some extra loud noise. String height on that is, you know, you can almost stick your finger under it. That's the way they work. Run a slide over it and you make a bunch of cool music. Lots of people do those and are amazingly good at playing them. So nice basic slide guitar. I then also make double neck slide guitars, which obviously have double necks and have different size necks on them, so you can hear different tones and everything like that. So slide guitars, fun guitars, probably the least expensive ones I make also, just because there's not frets and all the other jazz involved. Love them, they're great. It's the way blues actually started. Awesome stuff. So the most basic of my fretted instruments are kind of like this. They're not kind of, they are this. This one is a fully fretted guitar, 23 inch scale, like I said, my favorite. This one is a diatonic, which actually means that if we're looking at frets, you can kind of see here, it's missing some frets. And that's, so it's kind of a do re mi scale kind of a thing. I really like those. It's the way I started to learn how to play and then translate it over to one of these. Dulcimers and everything like that are all built that way, so they're really fun, like folky instruments. Love them. Basic thing with these guys is they got a little handmade bridge. A lot of times I have to put change underneath the bridges to get them to the right height so that they don't buzz and they're in the right intonation. Good solid fun guitars. If I was wanting somebody to have a guitar as a present, I'd probably almost go a diatonic at first, just because they can figure it out a little bit easier. Does limit the number of songs you can play, but there are a lot that you can, and you can actually put frets in. You know, if you look at this, there should be a fret here, and there should be a fret here, and there should be a fret there. Those can be actually put in. I mean, and the funny thing is that you are probably capable of doing it yourself. If somebody ever wanted a diatonically fretted guitar, but did want to have the option of putting frets in, I could go as far as to actually cut even fret spots in there and give you the frets that you could pop in if you needed to. It's really up to you as far as that goes. Really nice, fun guitars. Probably what I play the most are just these nice basic ones. They're just, like I said, great guitars. Ukuleles. This is a resonator ukulele with a nice little metal top on it. Looks pretty cool. So yeah, I can make ukes with different boxes and everything like that the same way I can. And I can actually make the standard 23-inch guitar with nylon strings, if that's what you would like. They're not actually nylon, but with uke type strings, just kind of what you like. But ukes, if you got somebody in the family that likes ukes, or you like ukes, these are nice. They're fun. They're handmade by these hands right here. This is what I call the 3-string, 6-string, 12-string thing. What I mean by that, it is set up like a 3-string in the sense that it is G, D, G tuning. I also mean that it is set up like a 12-string actual Rickenbacker, where it goes fat, skinny, and basically there's three sets of strings that are in octave of each other. Probably should have tuned that up before I made the video, but these are fun. This particular one happens to be diatonic. It is one that will probably stay with me for the rest of my life. I love this guitar. This box actually had some sort of painting over it, and when I sanded it off, it just turned out to be amazing. This is one of my favorite guitars I've ever built. It is obviously a double neck. It is a double deck diatonic. I think it's a, I want to say a 25, 23 on there. I love this guitar. If I'm out in the garage or shop or whatever you want to call it, this is a guitar that I pick up more often than not. With the exception of the metal looking one right there, which I can show in a minute. Love this guitar. Love it, love it, love it. Another guitar I make is what I call the cutting board guitar. Because it's the same way I make a cutting board, by gluing a bunch of wood together and then, blah, blah, blah. Actually, this one was fully finished and I stole all the parts to make Brandon's guitar because I didn't have parts and I didn't want to wait for him. I love these guitars. They're awesome. 23-inch scales, they're fun. If you want something that's kind of solid body-ish, well, not kind of, but is solid body, but want the old style, there you go.